want here in the room, so thank you for that. Only recently, I have to be honest, I learned that every year we have a theme that's consistent around the world for IWD. So I'm catching up as Rocky teaches me these things very quickly. And I thought a little bit about balance for better. And I reflected over the, I've been at Twitter over 4 years. It's one of the favorite companies to see us grow and do amazing things here. And what I reflected through Twitter, but also through events like this and forums like this, having seen a number of the companies that you all come from, our industry has put in a tremendous amount of effort to strive for balance over the last 4 years. And it's been good to see really good progress made in representation, gender representation, ethnicity representation, orientation, race, all of that, right? It's very top of mind for our industry, and it's great to see the progress we've made. And admittedly, there's a lot more that needs to happen as we sort of think beyond the first level of representation. And to me, this is where the conversation takes a very interesting turn. Balance for better, to me, is an opportunity to take the conversation from just numbers and balance to the notion of, does everybody feel a sense of belonging? And the belonging, whether it's in a company, in a team, in a meeting, in a board, in a networking event, how do we all strive that people feel truly like they belong? And that, to me, is the aspiration I carry as I look forward through the year. And this is a great way to start today here with our wonderful speakers. So you're here to hear them, not me. So no further ado, I'm going to actually invite our first speaker, Pranoti, to come on stage. A little bit about Pranoti. Pranoti has been a fourth generation mechanical engineer. I couldn't even comprehend that, but that's amazing. She's an inventor by her own right, but there were some clues that she was going to be an inventor from early on. So in her college days, she actually reinvented the iron. It blew my mind when I read that, but that's amazing. And she has come on now in more recent times to invent her next new invention, which I'll let her talk to you about. But she is the founder and CEO of Zimplistic, and they're in a number of markets, 30 markets or so, and she's driving the expansion of Zimplistic and managing the scaling up of that offering. So we're really excited to hear from you and hear about your story. Welcome, Pranoti. Yeah.
Thank you, Maya. I'm really excited to be here. Just give me a second. As you can see, I'm going to use a little bit of paper because sometimes the blood is all going here, so I might draw a blank. All right. So hi guys, my name is Pranoti and I'm the founder of Rotimatic. And I have a show of hands of me. How many people here have heard or eaten a roti or a chapati? Oh, wonderful. Okay, so now, can you make a guess on how many rotis are made in the world every day? Any guesses? 500 million.
Wow.
Let's see, any more guesses? No?
2 billion? 2, 3?
Close. 5 billion.
Wow.
So, to those who are not familiar, roti is a whole wheat flatbread. It's the best complex carbs you can have, and it's a staple for South Asians, but it is a pain to make. And on an average, an Indian woman spends about an hour making these fresh for her family every day. So what Rotimatic has done is it has enabled families across 20 countries to eat fresh homemade rotis with just a click of a button. So I want to take you back 10 years as I started the journey. That's the little me, and that's the big scary mountain, because it's an inspiration of changing millions of lives with one roti at a time. And for me, you know, I was 20-something when I quit my job and I started on this endeavor. in my lab. Imagine me in a lab trying to build a machine that mimics not just human dexterity, but the human judgment as well, because roti making is part art and part science, and putting all of it together. And I knew that, you know, this is a real case of biting more than I could have chewed, and this was a long and scary journey for me. But as today's topic is the woman who inspired you in your life, this is the best occasion I can think of when I can, you know, talk about this phenomenal woman who I'm fortunate to call my mother. Her name is Shalaka Nagarkar, and she's the one I give the credit for all my success to. And she's the one who basically has imbibed and taught certain things which I'm going to share with you today. You know, when you're under extreme pressure and when you're going through really tough phases, what happens is human instinct kicks in and you go back to your basics. And you start using things that you've imbibed while growing up. And today I want to talk to you about these five things which are like a secret sauce, because this has been a 10-year journey trying to scale this large mountain. And these are the things that have been inculcated by her in us as kids growing up, and has really been instrumental in helping us, you know, just take that one step at a time and keep going. So I hope that, you know, it'll help you to, you know, pick up one or two things in your pursuits and hopefully identify the superpowers that are already there within you. So there, here it goes. Rebel like a boss. So my mom was a total rebel. Imagine in India in the 70s, she would ride a motorbike, she played cricket, she had really long hair, she would do swimming every single day, but my grandmom didn't let her cut her hair. But you know, she danced to her own tune. And when I was doing Rotimatic, to do a company like Rotimatic, essentially you are creating a brand new category. It's a flatbread making robot. You've seen the kitchen of today. You have coffee machines, you have microwave ovens, you have rice cookers, but there's absolutely nothing for a flatbread. And you would imagine that a big company would have all the resources and deep pockets to actually create something like that. And when you know that the problem exists, how come nobody is doing anything about it? And that's when you have to realize that what you need is a startup mindset, honestly. Which will basically tell you that please don't follow what is the popular norm. You have to go against the tide. You have to disrupt, and you have to act like a rebel and create what needs to be created to change those millions of lives. And so for me, my mom growing up had set the baseline, a really high baseline. So whenever I was, uncomfortable or thinking about these things to go against the tide, I would always go back to this place of strength as a rebel, and it really helped us keep going. The other thing, okay, this is a million hand-drawn calendars. It's one of the things that my team often makes fun of me, because whenever I enter a meeting room and start the meeting, I start by drawing a calendar. It's a very small thing, a very simple thing, but this is one trait that I picked up from my mom, as she would, you know, multitask and manage millions of things, logistics and taking care of the family, my brother and me. And she would always start with a calendar, whatever the planning was. And, you know, it really helped me a lot in this journey of Rotimatic to scale up that mountain. Because, you know, in a startup, there's so many uncertainties, there's so many unknowns. And the ambiguity of things is just so much that you've got to zoom in, you've got to streamline, you've got to simplify. And a simple thing like drawing a calendar is something that really took me a long way. And you know, I think this is also something that, you know, you do one step at a time, and it helps you to worry less and just makes the journey a better, a more enjoyable one as well. Okay, this, I'll just give you a minute to read what it means. So this is another one of the things that she imbibed in us, this quality, this trait of titiksha. So you know, when you're building something difficult, you know that there are going to be long patches of lots of discomfort. And I remember it was exactly 6 years back. I was exactly in this situation with my first kid, a big belly, and we were running against a certain timeline because we had to, get the manufacturing going. And I remember driving all the way to Malaysia to meet suppliers and set up the manufacturing facility. And you know, you're going through a lot of mental stress as well as physical stress. But in those moments, this particular trait really helped me because, it's very easy to get stuck into your own general instincts that kick in at that time to pity and to feel that, oh, I'm doing all this, and you know, get tired and overwhelmed. But I think this quality of keeping a smile while enduring all of the physical and mental stress, it really takes you a long way. And I think that's one of the secret sauce to, you know, staying on course this long tenure Artemis journey. The other is, of course, fearlessness. And it's called nidartha in Hindi. And what it really means is that, you know, you just dive into the deep end, not be scared, not be afraid. I remember in 2014, and another of those moments when, you know, so with Rotimatic, we're not just doing the R&D and cracking the technology part of it, but we're also taking it all the way through, you know, other phases of manufacturing, productization. And there was a phase in 2014 when we had a lot of skepticism from the investors that, okay, this is, first of course, the technology that was crossed. Okay, now what about the market and will it accept a product like this? So there was a lot of skepticism we were going through. And I remember in moments like these, when you're pushed against the wall to take hard decisions, my mother would always, dive into the deep end and go to a place of strength and conviction and just make those calls. So in 2014, we made the call to launch the product through a pre-order campaign. And we had to stick our neck out. We had to go out there and talk to the audience and say, we are going to start taking orders. And on 26 June, we started taking orders, and we were pleasantly surprised. In our wildest imagination, we wouldn't have dreamed of a situation. We were sold out in 5 days, and very quickly, the skepticism of investors vanished. And those were some of the moments I remember having a lot of sleepless nights, being extremely scared. And that's when this particular thing kicks in. And I think it's an overall trait as an entrepreneur. I think it's one of the things you must have. And the bottom line to that is the inherent faith that you have. And it brings me to the fifth one, which is another thing that my mother made sure she ingrained in us, is that whatever you pick, the intention behind anything you pick, make sure that the purpose is strong and is beyond yourself. What it means is, it's not for your selfish needs, it's for something that is to fix a big problem or whatever it is beyond yourself. And I think, like they say, with great power comes great responsibility. And this is the kind of responsibility that you put on yourself to change millions of lives with one roti at a time or whatever that is. And it keeps you going because it's for somebody else. So somebody's got to do something about it. So I think that's something that really helped. And those are the five things that really helped me. And thanks to my mom, she's the one who inspires me even today as I'm going through me being a mother myself for the second time. And just some parting thoughts on what I am sort of working on currently is that, you know, you while you're on this journey, while we have Rotimatic in 50,000 homes and 20 countries, and now we're on our way to get to the next phase, there's still the journey is long, the mountain is still another mountain that you have to cross. What you have to keep doing is just keep going one step at a time, do your best, and then surrender to the rest. Thank you so much. Mm-hmm.